Kumusta kayong lahat? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. My name is PJ. Joining me is Marky Mark. If you haven't followed our social media, do so at Pinoy Crossover FTV or on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
So you can call it
and
Twitter.
YouTube. Marky Mark has been really taking over the Instagram, so he's going to be posting a lot of, not really memes, but a lot of showcasing a lot of different type of stuff. I'm excited for this episode because we have some highlights of the, you know, the kids playing in Malaysia.
Crossover Sports Canada team
with some of our little kids that we've watched play basketball, and Coach Mike and Coach Rod, and also the UAP people. Champions that have just been crowned.
You'll find out who won.
Yeah. So before we do that, let's go on to our little showdown to see who has some better answers. Let's go to the game floor.
Welcome to Pinoy Crossover Showdown. It's your host, Marky Mark, here at Throwing It Down with PJ. Are you guys ready? Camera off. First question. Who is the MVP of this season, LeBron or Harden? 3, 2, 1. LeBron.
Harden. Why you Harden? Go first.
I'm hosting. You shoot.
Whoa, okay. Harden is the MVP for the 2017-2018 season because, don't give me that face, Harden is it because he's been snubbed 2 times in a row. He's getting better at defense. How many memes of him not playing defense are there this year? No, not this year. Check the dates.
I'm gonna look
Check
for
the
it.
Dates. It's not LeBron because LeBron's old.
Not that
it's
old.
Not LeBron because his team is not doing as well as Houston. What's Houston's record right now? Better than Cleveland. Who's playing good? When Chris Paul was gone, who was playing good? Harden. If Harden wasn't playing, the whole team would collapse. He is gathering stats. He's playing MVP caliber. He should have won it. If it wasn't for the storyline of Russell Westbrook and his triple doubles, then he would have won it. Because Harden's playing MVP-like, and he's playing, and again, like you said, he was not a point guard. And he's playing amazing, phenomenal, getting a lot of points per game, assists per game. If you're talking about an MVP being, if the team were to fall apart without him, Harden is there. And Harden has been improving ever since. And I think he deserves to be that MVP this year.
Oh, you just gave me this one. So good, so good. But when Chris Paul went down, that's when James Harden started playing well because they didn't have any help. Well, LeBron has been doing it without ID for since the beginning of the season. They struggled. This guy had no help for the past since IT went down, since all the bench are too old. Derrick Rose left, and this guy played his best basketball right now, playing on his 15th year and has 58% shooting percentage and 41% from the line. This guy is getting triple doubles every single time, close to 28, 29 points in his 15th season. He's been carrying the league for at least since he started, since 2003. It's about time to give him the MVP because he's playing his best basketball. How come he's not getting MVP when he's playing his best basketball and he's been snubbed 3 or 4 times? Derrick Rose, when he won it, that should have been LeBron. One of Steph Curry's MVP should have been LeBron. KD's should have been LeBron. But he's always been underlooked because we always look for something good, something new, something shiny. But LeBron's been consistent, and they've been on a 13-game winning streak because of LeBron hitting game-winning shots and another game-winning shots again, Memphis and Sacramento. Because of him, they're playing well. Not anyone else.
Hold on, those teams aren't that good. You're talking about Harden and the Western
Harden,
Conference.
They're getting because they're outscoring everybody. Once
Absolutely.
Defense starts coming in,
Absolutely.
Nothing.
Absolutely.
Nothing. Next question. This is a good one.
Okay.
Who is the injury-prone guy that you want to build around? Mm-hmm. Embiid or Davis? 3, 2, 1. Embiid.
Davis.
Oh, I got this one.
Like
Embiid.
Okay, why?
Why Embiid? Because he plays it on both sides of the floor, but he's a lot younger than Davis. A lot younger than Davis. And he's got all the skill set that you need, like a Hakeem Olajuwon, with a three-point shot. How can you stop this guy? This guy can't. You need triple teams to stop this guy. And you can build around him, and that's what they're doing in the Sixers. They've been doing this in New Orleans, and nothing's ever happened. They've only had Embiid for 2 years, and they're a playoff contention team. How is that? Because Embiid is a better player to build around with than Davis because he can do both sides of the floor, he can shoot, and he's got better footworks, and he's been only for two, and he's fun. Everyone wants to watch
him. That's a point,
everyone,
and he's fun.
Social media.
I don't care about that.
Off the court, on the court.
And he's fun.
Everybody cares about it because who is paying Sixers fans? everyone around the world that are watching games, if someone's fun, they'd rather watch it. If you had to choose, who would you want to watch a game? Embiid or Davis, people are watching the Sixers because he's fun. He's always had active on social media, Twitter, Instagram. He's always up there. And I think he's going to be in the Hall of Fame.
You just threw that in there.
22-10. Only on his third season. Fourth season.
Whatever. Okay, so my point is that, you know, the process is just the process. That's why it's called the process.
And you gotta trust it.
Anthony Davis already is the finished product. He's already an all-star.
And
he's
where are they going?
Six seasons.
Where are they going?
What do you mean, where is he going? He can handle the ball better than, he can guard so many positions. Anthony Davis is lengthy. He's playing that trending game of a long. He can shoot threes. Remember in high school, he was
a beast.
He's
not as good of a shooter as Embiid.
Oh, we should put them on.
And you think he's the finished process? So, and
the finished process. He's not the finished product. I'm saying he's already an all-star.
And
he's
someone that you
want to build around. No, I don't. I think.
But they tried to build in New Orleans, and nothing's.
You just interrupted me now. That's how mad you are at Davis. Davis is a threat.
I had him in fantasy, and he always goes.
Are you gonna cry?
Yeah.
Anthony Davis is a better player to build around because he can guard so many different positions. He's versatile. He's proven to be a beast. He's not no process. He's been a beast in high school. He's been a beast in college, and he'll be a beast in the NBA. And he'll be in the All-Star game. And he did put All-Star numbers.
He won't be in the All-Star game this year.
Oh,
I bet you that, because DeMarcus Cousins is playing better than him.
Whatever, he's on my fantasy, and Anthony Davis is still giving me points. So,
if you had to watch a game, New Orleans or a Sixer game?
New Orleans.
Have you seen a New Orleans game?
Okay, but now you're doing my team.
Exactly.
You got Ben Simmons. What are these arguments? And he's fun.
Oh, if Embiid is, if Simmons is injured, and DeMarcus is injured.
You're changing the
question. Who would you watch a game?
No, we're talking about building a franchise.
Exactly.
Anthony
that
Davis,
comes into.
No,
makes
I want a veteran presence. I want someone who's been. And you said he's only. Embiid's only been in his third season.
He's younger.
He's still immature.
He's younger.
No, we're talking about Anthony Davis, who's seen a lot, who's been in the All-Star game, who's played a lot more seasons, who've got All-Star nods, who've got he got the accolades already. I'd rather build a team around him than being the process. I don't want to trust no process. I want to make sure my franchise is solid.